using it if I hit, you know, if I exceed my budget. I can't, sure, can't spend more money than I've been allocated, right?
Right.
They can't do that. They can, you set all kinds of alerts, right, to tell you you're getting close, you know, shut your stuff down. But if it's the weekend or you're on vacation or something like that, guess what? You're going to spend more money than was in your budget.
So there's no stop loss kind of a thing.
Right. There's no way.
You have to automate that.
I mean, so now you could probably hire a service to do that, though, right?
More budget.
You could have the alert sent somewhere and use the API to turn your machine off, though, right?
Yeah.
You'd have to have some tooling for it.
Is there a way to run an automated application where you check all these figures?
Yeah, so they have something that will notify you. I'm sure you can use a Lambda service to kick off, you know, here's an event that has occurred, let's, you know, shut everything down.
Instead of you watching it, the app that you've designed,
yep,
or is available.
I'm sure so does. There's tons of vendors out there. I went to this thing and they had, you know, the room was twice as big as our room here with every table was, you know, someone was fantastic. They had these big displays. You know, Cloud Checker was a big one, and they have all these little tools for checking what's going on in your cloud. And so Amazon, these other vendors, say that their environment is more secure than yours is, right? So they have everything locked down. If you want to do like a port scan or something like that, you can't do that on Amazon. They won't want you to do that. If you're going to let them do a port scan, you have to let them know ahead of time so they can shut off all their, you know, emergency warning stuff.
Yeah.
You see, like, you know, Star Trek Enterprise, where whoop, 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 you know. So they have a lot of things that they have available. And
you've got about 2 minutes.
Yeah, okay, so then I've got 10 slides. You can see that there's all kinds of different services that they're doing, right? Disaster recovery is one of the things that they're offering up and saying. You can have a warm system, you can have a cold system.
Sure.
You have all this stuff up there. And so they have, you know, actual prices for this, this slide here. So, you know, for $309 a month, you can have a Direct Connect pilot-like thing, which is just, you know, a real... a system that's, you know, warm system with a, you know, real good connection and stuff like that, just sitting there waiting for you. It's a whole bunch of different things that are, you know, optimizing, getting your system set up properly. So service-oriented architecture was another big presentation there. So one of the things you want to be aware of is if you're taking an existing old application and you're moving it to the cloud, if it's not designed for the cloud, there's going to be a big bill to make that happen, right? Very careful about just taking old stuff and throwing it into the cloud if it's not designed to do that. So there it could be more pricey. You know, I've heard things, oh yeah, Amazon's so cheap. It's, you know, yeah, the CPU cycles are cheap, and, you know, some of the services for storing data is cheap. But if you're just going to throw something in there, you know, then you have to be careful about it. And there are services, there's companies that will take your virtual machines on premises and put them in the cloud for you with this wonderful tooling and all that. You know, wonderful, I think I've got a slide on that too. So security hacking, I think, you know, mentioned that they think that they're better than you are, and, you know, well, that's not the way to say it. I mean, they think their security is really good. So you're not likely to run into a risk, according to them. And they can watch stuff for you. They have monitors and stuff like that to help you. If something goes wrong, they'll let you know. So it's Cloud Checker, and there's the guy's name and all that stuff. So the key management, there's a whole information overload on how this, you know, all can be worked out and more, you know, eliminate and fix vulnerabilities. And, you know, so they're watching this stuff. There's something like a Heartbleed or something like that in their environment. They will go in and make it fixed, right? So you don't have to do as much administration on the infrastructure side, right? They have some new services coming out, Beanstalk. So they have, you know, development environments, cloud formation. This is a whole, you know, catalog of different things that you can integrate in. And then there's, you know, the virtual private gateways. So again, you can set up your own private little areas and manage that, you know, as long as, you know, as much as you want to. You can, you know, lock things up so that, you know, only this cluster can do something and only that cluster. So what they were suggesting is, you know, much like the traditional environment, you have a back end that's really highly protected. You have a front end that might be more exposed. And these two things can talk to each other without anybody else hitting them or finding them. So that's what I had prepared as my presentation.
Is there any way you can share that, or is it really confidential, like it says in the bottom?
Yeah, so this is a formatted document that I grabbed. So I don't really think this is confidential. All these bullet points that I grabbed were, you know, presented at their, at the Amazon.
If you could share that on the mailing list, that'd be great.
Yeah, I will find a way to share.
I'd love to read it in detail.
I've heard about this thing called, what is it, something share?
Slideshare. Slideshare.net.
Yeah, so maybe I can comment on that.
May I have your attention? The time is now 8:45, and the library will be closing in 15 minutes at 9 p.m. The library internet connection will shut down approximately 10 minutes before closing.
So, you want to ask some questions, or we really need to...
No, we need to get on.
If you have questions, yeah, go ahead and ask them.
Excellent. Okay. We have some giveaways, so if you, do this quickly here.
Can I get a show of hands for who's going to dinner tonight with us? Let me get a count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I see 9, I think he's a 10, Gibbs 11. Okay, good, I'm gonna tell him like 15.
Anybody, any more here?
All right, so we got some giveaways to...